In this basin, there are all sorts of items. A broken motorcycle spark plug, an old electrical plug, wires, a few crocodile clips, and other small tools. Looking at them, many people might think, this is all junk, but the DIY spirit. We will turn them into materials for an interesting experiment too, taking the spark plug and the plug among these items. I choose a spark plug and an electrical plug. Spark plug, an important component in a motorcycle engine, responsible for creating the spark that ignites the fuel. Plug, the connector between the power source and the device. When placing them side by side, I came up with an idea. Combine them to make a special drill bit. 3. Dismantling the plug to take the metal prong next. I dismantled the plug. Inside are two metal prongs, originally used to connect with the socket. I carefully remove one prong, keeping the shiny metal part. Even though it is old, the copper material is still solid and conducts electricity well. For attaching the prong to the spark plug and fitting it into the drill then, I try attaching the plug's prong to the spark plug head. They fit together quite snugly. I take an old drill and clamp the spark plug into its chuck. It feels like I am creating a new tool, strange but exciting. 5. Sharpening. The spark plug with a grinder for the spark plug to work as a drill bit. I need to sharpen it. I turn on the grinder, run the drill, and press the spark plug against the cutting wheel. Sparks flash. The sound of metal grinding rings loudly. The smell of hot metal drifts through the air. After a few minutes, the spark plug tip becomes sharp, like a steel drill bit. Six. Preparing wood in a vise now. Prepare a small piece of wood and clamp it tightly in a vise. The vise holds the wood firmly, preventing it from moving while drilling. This step is important for safety and precision. 7. Drilling a hole with the spark. PLUGI switch on the drill and drive the sharpened spark plug into the center of the wood block. The sound screeches and a faint smell of burnt wood appears. After a few minutes, a round hole forms in the middle of the wood. I am surprised that the spark plug drills wood quite well, proving the idea is not meaningless. 8. Threading wire and connecting to the spark plug after, making the hole. I take a piece of wire and thread it through. One end of the wire is connected to the spark plug, fixed tightly to ensure electricity can flow through. Point 9. Attaching a crocodile. Clip the other end of the wire is attached to a crocodile clip. Crocodile clips are familiar tools in electrical experiments, allowing quick and secure connections. 5.10. Making a second wire rye, also make a second wire, with crocodile clips on both ends. This way, I can easily connect different devices during the experiment. Experimenting with a battery and a razor blade next. Take a battery and place a razor blade on top. The idea is to create a simple weld using the battery's current. I clip one end of the wire to the razor blade. Then I touch the spark plug tip to the blade to generate sparks and weld the blade to the battery. A flash appears. The metal melts slightly, forming a simple joint. 12. Testing with aluminum foil after. Experimenting with the razor blade. I take a piece of aluminum foil. I connect the wire and touch the spark plug to the foil to check conductivity. The foil lights up, proving that electricity has passed through dot 13. The meaning of the experiment. Thus, from items that seem like trash, we successfully created a small tool to test electricity. This is not only a creative play, but also proof of recycling and reusing old materials. 14. Scientific analysis. Spark plug. Works on the principle of generating sparks. Plug and prong, good conductors, easy to reuse. Crocodile clips. Allow quick, convenient connections. Battery and razor blade illustrate a simple welding phenomenon. Aluminum foil verifies electrical conductivity. Each step brings excitement, like a miniature journey of scientific discovery. From sharpening the spark plug drilling wood, to experimenting with the battery and foil, all show that creativity has no limits. Finally, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Don't forget to support the amazing Smart Channel for more exciting DIY ideas.